Thank you, God, for traveling grace. Made it to Marrakesh. It is freezing right now. I'm just vibing off of 2 hours of sleep. So, this is so cool. So, yeah, I don't know. I think I might end up sleeping the whole fucking day. But we'll see, because I need to get my energy up. So I'm ready to give you 3 shots of espresso. So as soon as I walk out from the terminal, there's these cabbies. And they should have numbers on them if they're real cabbies. So I'm already fucking irritated by how they be ripping people off here, because from the airport to here was like maybe $15, and this man tried to charge me 40 dirhams. No, 400 dirhams. Should have got like 100, but I didn't have change. See what I'm talking about? Bargaining. I need to break my dirhams up, because they're not about to fucking snatch my money up like that. And now I'm walking to my hotel because he didn't even drop me off where I needed to go. Like, yo, I'm so pissed already by that. Tell y'all that this has been probably one of the most frustrating moments of this trip. Seriously, so got into Morocco today around 8-ish, 9, 10. Anyways, got to my hotel, did not sleep, just dove right into creating content. And then I ended up falling asleep at 6, and I ended up waking up at 12. And ever since I woke up, I've been responding to like my DMs and talking to you guys. And that has taken like 3 hours just because all of the birthday wishes. I literally had a whole emotional, like I was just overwhelmed and thankful for all of the birthday love and like the love, the genuine love that I'm feeling from my tribe. There's just no way that no one can tell me that God does not exist. Even obviously things aren't always perfect, but I just feel like I'm prepared. God has prepared me to face anything and has put the right people in my life always. But I just want to tell y'all again, watching this vlog, thank you so much for the birthday wishes. Tomorrow is gonna be a chill day. I'm gonna go to the souk, souk. Okay, and then one of those has to be right. And then I'm doing a pottery class, which I'm so excited for, because I've always wanted to like make the pottery, not paint it, actually make it. So that's what I'll be doing tomorrow. And yeah, I'm gonna be doing the camel ride. I'm gonna be here for like 5 days, so I have enough time to like do a bunch of stuff. So all right, y'all, I'm going to take my ass back to sleep, or at least try to take my ass back to sleep, and I will talk to you guys in the morning. To you, the birds are chirping. Okay, so I'm actually getting ready to move to my other room. because I don't read, when I booked this place, I did not know that they had a separate location 15 minutes from here, and it's their private Riyadh. And anyway, so I was gonna move there today, and there happened to be an availability here, so I'm staying here, but I'm just moving downstairs. I had to download this map called Maps Me. It's way better than using Google Maps, for sure. It actually takes you down like all the little mini streets and lets you know where to turn and stuff. Especially since every little corner, every little alley looks exactly the same. Very easy to get lost. So definitely make sure to download Maps Me.
Oh, this is so cute.
Thank you.
I like it.
Thank you. Thank you. Nobody looks like me here, that's for sure. Okay, so I'm having lunch up there at whatever, however you say this name. Tadera's de Spices. I think I did a good job saying that. Y'all, I found a rooftop. Yes to the lamb. It looks like rice, but it's couscous. This is couscous. This is couscous. Y'all, look at this. It's a napkin. It's growing. $100, I have to put this in my bag very quickly, then you get the conversion, right? That just made it so easy to understand. Okay, I can tell y'all now, they will try to take your money. So you really need to negotiate, like negotiate for real, for real. See, my friend, see that he tried to charge me 400 dirhams for the shoes, and I just got all of these bracelets. For 500, I got 5 bracelets and a ring. So, look, he's trying to charge me 400 dirhams, which is $40 in US dollars. This is not worth 400 dirhams, guys.
Nice color, nice quality.
It is, but 200 dirhams.
What you want to get?
Let's see.
How much you
say this price? 200.
How much did you end up? Between, not 300 dirhams, not 200 dirhams. 250.
250?
250, it's good for
250. I could do 250. My friends, you need to. I'm telling you. whiskey.
Yes.
When I come back, I am definitely coming back with an empty suitcase. Because y'all know, I'm so like, I like resort wear stuff and I like anything that's tropical or exotic. So the stuff here has, I'm gonna leave inspired to really shop for my home because man, like it's beautiful here. And I feel so safe here too. That's another thing. I feel extremely safe. Like even though, yeah, people are looking and they're like, oh my gosh, you know, who's that? Who's that? But, and they think I'm famous, but whatever. Yeah. So, pretty much everyone's really friendly and there's actually laws here that really protect American citizens. All of the accessories, including the shoes, I got for under $100, 80 bucks. Woo, child. Be careful out here. The motorcycles, they come so close to you, like, oh my God. This is how I do my hijab situation. So I get this, come here, and then I would like tuck behind my ears. It's nice if you have like a safety pin or something. I take this, and then I take this. Okay, this is the nightlife here. It's a whole strip. This is like a club and a restaurant. Yeah, okay. So I literally walked from my last hotel to where I am now. Okay, thank you so much. I'm always tripping, guys. Oh my gosh, this is so pretty. And they greeted me with a towel. Like, oh, y'all fancy here. I'm doing a pottery class.
Yeah, I want to make this size. Like, that size is perfect.
Okay. Now, I'm going to use the wheel. This is the moment that I've been waiting for, guys. The pottery class was so much fun. And I just want to shout out again to Airbnb Experience. It makes it so easy to do solo travel and still be able to like make friends and find activities wherever you're traveling. I was not sponsored by Airbnb to tell y'all this. This is just something that I did on my own, and it's definitely clutch. Okay, definitely clutch. Today is a busy day, so I was able to just change really fast because I'm getting ready to go do the camel ride. This is my camel outfit. You like it? Okay, I'm just running. My eyeshadow matches my outfit. Okay, so this is another Airbnb experience, and it was a very good price. It was like $22, and it includes transportation to and from, and it's a deal. I'll make sure to put the link. Guys, what are they doing to me? Look at this nonsense. First of all, I had a cute outfit. Look at what they're doing to my head. Okay, so this is tradition, I'm assuming, so to protect my head. I look Arabian. Feel like I look like Conehead. Do not look like Conehead. What's it?
Look like it's a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. Like it's a hug.
So this is definitely not the Sahara. Yeah, I couldn't deal with them with that thing on my head. That was not cute. We stopped off real quick into this village, and they had this tent set up for us here, and they gave us tea and biscuits and bread. This reminds me of Trinidad. You know how they have the chicken coop and you get fresh eggs and chicken? And then this is the inside.
Hello.
Hi.
Hold on, hold on, hold on. Don't take.
And have shisha, and I'm going to have it here. I'm crying because I'm just so thankful. Like, I was eating breakfast, praying, meditating by the water. I'm very connected to the water. And I had to stop what I was doing and just pray. God is so good. I feel Him all around me. And every person that I meet, I am overwhelmed with love, and I'm just so thankful. I'm so thankful. Wow. I knew I was gonna cry, but guys, I'm leaving my family. I'm gonna ride on the motorcycle, guys! most authentic looking in regards to architecture. It's extremely beautiful if you look at the details here.
That's your Moroccan tea.
Thank you. And you know they love their tea here. This is their patio area and their pool. Look at their pool. This reminds me of Jungle Book. Like, look at how the briny is so beautiful. Look at that. I burn my Palo Santo wood in peace while I'm sleeping at night, and not to mention it smells really great. I pretty much just walk around, cleanse the room, any energies, I'm ready to explore. So I already did some exploring. This is an actual palace and it is humongous. So many like turns, and this is it. Yes, so this part is 200 years old, y'all. It blows my mind is the fact that this was all made by hand. Yeah, they got me. I was walking away perfectly fine and they just
started.
So listen, so I go, right? And then they do the henna for me. And then she tried to charge me 400 dirhams. I was like, you can fucking take this $100. This is what you can take, that 100 dirhams and keep it going. She's like, no, I need some more money. No, I told your ass before you did my henna that I didn't have no goddamn money for you. Okay, so it is so easy to find a cab driver around here.
دائما الساعة العاشرة صباحا لنذهب إلى حديقة ماجورين وإلى مسجد الكتبية ونفعل جولة كبيرة في مراكش.
I told you to wake up at 10 in the morning to go to the Marjorelle Garden and to the Kebir Mosque and benefit from the great tour in Marrakesh.
Okay. No, I would like to see more of Marrakesh. Something beautiful to take pictures, possibly. This is how you make argan oil.
Yeah.
You put the argan
nuts, almonds,
the
yes.
almonds
of argan
inside of here.
Yes.
And then
with round?
You turn it,
yes.
So
round with Weber machine.
And then it comes out.
Yeah, paste, as a paste.
It smells really good.
Yes, because this is argan for eating.
For eating?
Yeah, we roast the argan almonds. For cosmetic, not roasting of argan almonds.
It's like peanut butter.
Yeah.
So I came to Elfin. It's a hotel here, and I was very close to booking this hotel actually, and low-key kind of upset that I did not, because it is gorgeous. This is their rooftop. I saw the rooftop from my Riyadh, and I had to come over here and see what was popping. Sneak and try to record as much as I can before I leave. But this is one of the expensive hotels.
It's so big.
Oh my gosh, that's cute. This property is really big, y'all. It's gorgeous. I was just on my way out. I just wanted to get another sneak peek. Yo, this place is amazing. I'll be back. I'm not even tripping, because I will be back.
Like a motherfucking boss.
First day in Morocco, enjoying and absorbing the Moroccan sun. The sun hits kind of different in Africa, just saying. So today I don't have to be at the airport until 4. So I'm going to see if I can sightsee and do some stuff. I have a driver that's been the same driver that's been taking me around everywhere. So yeah, just gonna have some tea, create some content for this cute ass. Ooh, I need to fix that, but create content for this outfit, and then we out. Okay, y'all, so I came to La Mamouna hotel, and I've heard great things in regards to like capturing photos, and the garden is here, but it is so racist. Oh my god, like this old lady saw me and literally dropped her fork. Like she was looking at me like, how did she get in here? Like, what is she doing here? And you can tell by the price points that it's like a certain type of people here, you know, and they do it on purpose. I had to get out. Like, it was literally a get out situation. Yeah, it's great for taking pictures, but is it worth it? Is it worth feeling uncomfortable and getting stares left and right? Never, never. Last stop before heading back to Barcelona. This is the Garden La Jordan. But Yves Saint Laurent is the one who designed this beautiful place. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Definitely must come. It is 70 dirhams, which is $7. Okay, so my perspective on this trip has changed a lot. I thought that people were staring at me because they were like being rude, but they're staring at me because I'm pretty and they've never seen me before and they don't know how to say I'm pretty. So when people stare at you in countries where there's not a lot of black people, it's not because they're racist, it's just because you're beautiful. Okay.
J'adore.
Hi.
J'adore.
Hi, j'adore.
They thought I was pretty.
Yeah.
Trinidad.
Trinidad. It's a Caribbean island. Yeah.
Caribbean.
I'm Caribbean, yes.
Really? In Caribbean, everything woman is.
Yes, it's true.
Very cool.
Thank you. Okay, yeah, come on.
That's really funny that literally I just proved my own point when I said that, and then literally I'm taking pictures, everyone's taking pictures of me. It's really nice. I feel like anywhere you go, there's gonna be people that are gonna stare because they're jealous of you because you're pretty. But for the most part, people are very nice. If you have good energy always comes back to you. So do not be discouraged. Go on that solo trip, sis. You will make friends along the way.
Everything was going great until my cab driver tried to take me back to his place because he wanted to have sex with me. Okay. I'm very uncomfortable right now, y'all.
I really do not want that situation to discourage you from doing a solo travel. That's why I want to stress the importance of sharing your itinerary with your closest friends and family, making sure that you have your location settings on at all times with somebody that you trust and that you know will check on you to make sure that you're safe. And yeah, just constantly communicating with your loved ones to and from where you're going. And then also another thing is to make sure that you on your Instagram, if you can, if you make friends in that city, tag them on Instagram, and so therefore your followers and the people who's watching you knows who the last person you were with. If anything were to happen to you, they would be able to, you know, kind of keep a paper trail and backtrack to make sure, because yeah, it's tough out here for a black woman, especially us, because we're like very fetishized and we're very sexualized and everybody wants to fuck us. And that's just the reality of the situation. So it's just very important for us to be extra, extra careful when we travel, and especially when we go to countries where there's not a lot of black people, because we're seen as exotic and we're beautiful. And yeah, it's crazy that to me that this happened in Morocco, because I was expecting this to happen in Barcelona because they see black women as prostitutes in Barcelona. But yeah, I mean, yeah, that situation was crazy. But I just thank God that I made it to the airport safely. And yeah, trust yourself, have discernment, and yeah, just be safe out there, guys. So I made it back to Barcelona. Tomorrow I go back to the airport, and my flight leaves at 10. So literally don't have any time to do anything other than sleep and wake up and head to the airport. So here we go. It's gonna be a long journey back to the States.
Woo! Mm-hmm. Ow. Damn, ow. Damn, I forgot I put bobby pins in here. Oh my gosh. Listen, I have absolutely no regrets. This trip was worth it. I'm feeling more empowered than I've ever felt before. You can't tell me nothing. Like, I did this shit. Like, and it feels so amazing to say that I really did this. Like, I'm just so proud of myself that I pushed myself to do something so adventurous, I guess, and be fearless like this. Like, it's crazy. I was confident before, but this trip, I definitely feel invincible. Definitely. God is good. I thank him for traveling grace every day. He was by my side. I wasn't alone at all on this trip. I had you guys. I was talking to y'all like the whole time. Y'all was giving me advice. Making sure I was safe too. Got my tribe with me. I love y'all. I really hope that I motivated some women to ignite this power within them, because we're all strong and we're all fearless, to take a leap of faith and do a solo trip. At least one time. Start off small, do a domestic trip first, and then, you know, take that leap of faith and travel and see the world, because you can do this. I promise, you got this, sis. Definitely. Just be safe, be responsible. The same things that can happen in other countries can happen in America. Let's keep it real. And especially with the racial tensions and shit, and the black women showing up missing in America, shit, I felt safer in Morocco than I did in my own goddamn country. Let's just say that much. So, listen, if you can survive America, you can survive anywhere. And that's the real tea.